This training video from the Penn State Institute for Cyber Science is designed to help you work with our high-performance computing system, the Advanced Cyber Infrastructure, or ICS-ACI for short. In this video, you'll learn how to use Globus, a research data management tool. Penn State has an institutional account with Globus. To use this tool, go to the Globus website, globus.org, and click on Log In. Then, from the pull-down list of organizations, choose Penn State. The first time you use Globus, there's a simple sign-up process. After that first sign-up, you'll just enter your Penn State user ID and password to log in, and follow the usual two-factor authentication process. So here's what the Globus interface looks like. To transfer files using Globus, you have to define the endpoints, the locations from which and to which you want to transfer files. There are two classes of endpoints: server endpoints, for example, a multi-user storage system, and personal endpoints, for example, your laptop. To transfer and share data from your personal computer, you have to first add it to your endpoints. To do this, click on Endpoint at top right, and then click on Add Globus Connect Personal Endpoint. Give your endpoint a name. Here, we've used ACI User Laptop. Remember that each endpoint should have a unique name. Now click the Generate Setup Key. When the key has been created, copy it to the clipboard. The next step is to choose your operating system and download the Globus Connect Personal installer. When the download is complete, click to run the installer. You're offered a default directory location for your Globus installation. This should be fine for your purposes. And click Install. In the Setup wizard, keep this box checked. When you see the prompt Set Up Endpoint, paste the key you generated and copied to the clipboard at the beginning, and hit OK. By default, Global Connect Personal accesses your home directory. But you can change that and specify which directory you want Globus to access. Now your computer is connected to Globus via Globus Connect Personal. You have the ability to transfer and share files. Let's step through transferring a file from your home directory to a remote directory. Select your first endpoint. Here, we're selecting the endpoint we defined at the beginning of this session, your personal computer. In the Path field, this symbol, a tilde between two slashes, indicates that you are in the home directory on the endpoint ACI User Laptop. Now select the second endpoint. The endpoints on the remote machines are established by local administrators. You'll choose the endpoint you want from the list provided. Here, we start typing PENN in the endpoint box, and the list of available Penn State endpoints shows up. The three endpoints you see here highlighted in yellow are the endpoints available on the ICS-ACI system. Search for your directory within the Scratch folder or group. It's the one labeled with your Penn State ID. In the left panel, choose the file or files you want to transfer, and click on the right arrow to transfer data from the endpoint on the left, your computer, to the endpoint on the right, ICS-ACI file storage. You'll see a message confirming that your transfer request has been submitted. At this point, Globus takes over to handle data transfer. You can navigate away from this page, close the browser, or even log out, and your transfer will not be affected. When your data transfer is complete, you'll get a detailed email notification from Globus. If you get a message that the transfer is complete, but you can't see the transferred files, click on Refresh List, and you should be able to see them. So that's a brief introduction to Globus and how to use it to transfer a file from your personal machine to the remote desktop on the ICS-ACI system. We've got more training videos on our website, ics.psu.edu.